Well, hello everybody. Today we're going to do a review on the new Connex 3300 FHP. Brand new radio out from Connex. Just got it in today. 3300 radio with frequency counter built in. Kind of cool. Something new anyway. Alright, so let's turn this thing on. We'll let you get an idea of what it looks like, and we'll go over some of the features, and then we'll go over the inside of the radio. Okay, we got the radio on. Zoom back a little bit so you can see the whole face. It is blue. One thing that you'll notice, that there's the last digit in the frequency counter, is says D. That's actually your band, and we'll show you how to operate that here in just a minute. Let's get in here and take a look. You got your mic connector, volume squelch, your mic gain, your RF gain, echo, time and delay, AM FM PA, talkback, and RF power. So it does have variable talkback. It's kind of cool. Up on our buttons, you'll see that we have Roger Beep, 10 kilohertz switch, SWR for automatic SWR meter, noise blanker, dimmer, and your band selector. Okay, so how that band selector works is you just push your band selection button. E, F, A, B, C, D. Very simple to change bands. Your dimmer dims it down. Actually dims it down pretty nicely too. That's one of the things that's pretty bright and obtrusive. This dims it down to a much more manageable level for night driving. I like that feature. Okay, that's pretty much a quick rundown of the front. Let's take it apart and see what it looks like inside. Okay, we've got the cases off. We're going to do a quick scan of the back side of the board. This is the solder side. And zoom in where you can see that it is a dual MOSFET radio. Everything else is fairly straightforward. Do have a cap over here that they're trying to work with the talkback on. I haven't heard the talkback yet, so I don't know how good it sounds. But pretty much a standard, what you're used to seeing. The board on this particular radio, and I'll zoom in so you can see it. It's an EPT3615C. So it is using the 3600 board. I didn't think it would, but by golly it did. Let's flip it over. And we'll give you a tour of the inside. Okay, as I said earlier, your two output transistors, your driver, pre-driver, SWR board, pretty standard. Your input, ferrite coil, cap. This is your echo board. The layout, everything in the board itself is fairly simple. It's similar, you know, it's a 3600 board, something we've all seen. Here's the biggest thing. I want to zoom in on this. This is the new channel selector board. And why in God's creation they did this, I have no idea, but I want to show you. I normally don't show you the conversion, but I'm going to show you this one. Because when you get the radio, this is how you'll see it. You've got two black jumpers there. No markings. And if you also notice, you get a key. Let me zoom out. That's set up to have some type of a plug to guide you in. However, it doesn't have. This is the same number of pins as each one of these. And there's no way of knowing which one does what or how it does it. Kind of interesting there, isn't it? So, it goes on the right side. Bear with me while I line this up. Alright, so when you turn this radio on, the good news is, if you turn it on and you're wrong, it's not going to blow the radio up. However, it's not going to work. It's not going to convert properly either. So, the way this thing goes in the right one. And if you see here on this connector, bear with me, these two marks go toward the front. for conversion. Do not plug anything into this pin. The right side, and have the connector orientation facing the front. All right, that'll get you where you want to be. Okay guys, so now we've got the radios converted, of course. I haven't touched the thing, it's just factory stock. I want to show you what this thing does, and then we'll show you what it does with a good quick tune. Give you an idea what kind of radio it is. Just a second. All right, we're back. So our settings are, our mic gain is wide open, our RF power is all the way down. We'll go up to the meter. Still using a 50 watt slug in the X1 position. About 3 watts dead key. Okay, we're going to modulate. Audio, hello, 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 ah. 10 watts with the RF power all the way down. Now I'm turning the RF power all the way up. We have about 14 watt dead key. Hello, hello, audio, hello, hello, hello. ish, something like that. It'll peak up around 50 and then drop back to 35. Let's see what happens after it's tuned. Be right back. Okay guys, we're back. We've done just I guess what you'd call a standard tune, just something like most shops do, just a quick clip and snip, I guess. Although I didn't snip the limiter out, but I did do a quick tune on it. We'll do a quick check up here, show you the dead keys still. I actually haven't adjusted the dead key, so let me turn the mic gain down. And I got this switch in the wrong position. There we go. Still 50 watt slug, X1 position. Still at a 3 watt dead key. Okay. RF power is down. We're in the X2 position, which is going to be the 100 watt scale. And if I don't turn the mic gain up, we'll never see anything. Hello. Damn. Sorry. Put it on peak. Hello, audio. Hello, hello, hello. Hello, audio. Hello, hello, hello. 60 watts with the RF power on low. We're going to turn the RF power up on high. Hello, audio, 1-2 test, 1-2 test. Still about 60 watts. So with just a minimal tune, we've come up from 10 watts on low to 60. RF power on high, come up from 30 watts to 60 watts. And that guy said that's with no major tune, just a pretty much a standard clip and snip. So the power came up pretty good. So let's, I would say probably 70 watts would be about where this radio would be. Maybe a little more, depends. Next thing I want to show is the receive on this. So give me just a second to set that up. We'll be right back. Okay, we're back. We've got our signal generator on. I don't have any idea if you can see this meter. I'm going to zoom in, try to show you. That's where we're at. But tonight, or today, I'm going to do something a little different. We're going to go up to the bigger. Let me get this paper out of here. We're going to go up to the bigger vacuum tube voltmeter. And we're going to run the receive. Give you a little better chance to see, just real quickly, what we can do, if anything. Sorry, it's hard to adjust this, and when I look my head down, thank you. So our receive has come up. My handle quit drifting down. You can see where we're at there. That's just with a quick. And if you come over here and look at the meter, you can see that we've came up quite a bit. And that's just with some real simple tweaking, not a full alignment by any way, shape, or form. So ultimately, we've got that taken care of. I want you to hear the echo in the talkback, and then we'll sum this thing up. Be right back. Okay, guys, we're back. We've got our talkback on. Turn the echo off. All right, so here's our talkback with on off, and it is adjustable. So let's turn the talkback on. Test 1-2. Test 1-2. Hello, hello. I don't know if you can hear that, but it sounds pretty crappy. Test 1-2, test 1-2. As you turn it up, it does have a little better sound. Test 1-2, test 1-2. As you get it up a little higher, you see the talkback does come in. Sounds pretty bad low, but it's not too bad there. So you can actually hear how the talkback sounds on the radio. We're going to switch the echo on. Test 1-2-3. Audio test 1-2-3-4. Let's make some more adjustments. I'm going to turn it up where it's probably obnoxious. Test 1-2. 1-2-3. Audio test. Hello. Hello. Okay. Pretty much that's how it's going to sound. Now I can probably do some mods to the talkback to make it sound a little better out of the box. But as it comes out of the factory, that's how it sounds. All right. Sorry, guys. Alright, to sum this up, I guess what you've got here is a Connex 3300 HP with a frequency counter, which we all knew. Not bad. It's got some issues. The talkback needs a little work. It's going to tune up pretty decent. Receive's not bad on it. It's got a really nice set of faceplate as far as it's simple to operate. Not a whole lot of buttons and gizmos to mess with. Everything's fairly straightforward. One of the things I do like is the dimmer function, which I'll show you again. Maybe. That's the Roger beep. There's our bright. And there's dim. And I really think that's going to satisfy a lot of you guys out there on the road or wherever you have it, that this is dimming down enough that it really does make it nice. The channel band changing, it's really simple. As we just push the button in, nothing really difficult about that. It is displayed prominently in the frequency counter side. Got all the features, echo, talkback, RF power, everything on the front. Pretty nice looking little radio. I think it's going to be a good radio. I'm pretty impressed so far. With the talkback issue we'll have to work on. We'll do a full tune up on it, and I expect to see 70 plus watts out of it. Just something brand new. I wanted to get it out here and let you guys have a chance to look at it firsthand before most people had an opportunity to get it. We do have them, a few of them actually. They're in very short supply right now, but if you need more information, you can check us out on the web at www.customcbradios.com. Or check out our Facebook page at Custom CB Radios on Facebook. I post a lot of information and stuff like that on Facebook for everyone. So this is CB Repairman. Hope you enjoyed it. And until the next time, have a great day.